morning, everyone, and welcome to Children's Chapel. I'm Miss Brooke, and I am so excited to be here with you today as we approach May 9th. Does anyone know what day is May 9th? It's a very important holiday. Is it Christmas? No. Is it Easter? Well, actually, kinda. It's the fifth week of Easter, but that's not what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about another exciting and beautiful holiday. One where we give thanks to our family and our mothers. It's Mother's Day, and I am so excited to talk to you about Mother's Day in our children's chapel. But before I do that, and after our candles are lit, could we please sing together our gathering song? Come everybody, gather together. Come everybody, gather together. Come everybody, gather together. Come let us worship our God. Oh, that was great. Okay. So today I have made you main points. Can you do two fingers, two main points that I want to share with you. Number one, I want to talk about how our love for God and our parents, our mothers included, and especially for Sunday, are alike. Those loves are similar. And number two, I want to think together about all the reasons that we have to be grateful for our mothers. And to do that, I thought that I would share an art project with you that I would love for you to try at home. Okay, so what was the first point? How is our love for God and our mothers alike? In the Bible, Jesus said to his disciples, or as we know, his friends, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Stay in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy," joy like happiness, "may be in you and your joy may be complete." Wow, that's a lot of words, but I brought in a new song that maybe will help us unpack it a little bit. Are you ready for our new song? It's called "This Is My Commandment."
Commandment that you love one another, that your joy may be full. This is my commandment that you love one another, so that your joy may be filled. Your joy may be full. Joy may be full. This is my commandment that you love one another. Joy may be full. My commandment that you love one another, your joy may be full. This is my commandment that you serve one another, so your joy may be full. Your joy may be full. Joy may be full. This is my commandment that you serve one another. Joy may be full. My commandment that you love one another, that your joy may be full. My commandment that you love one another, that your joy may be full. by commandment that you love one another, so your joy may be full.
Thank you for singing with me. I think that really helps get at what Jesus was trying to teach us. What were words that you heard in that song? I heard the word commandment again and again. What is a commandment? Well, a commandment is when someone gives you an instruction and you respond by obeying it. And that is how our love for God and our love for our parents is alike. In both cases, we show that we have love by obeying. Now, it's very important that we think about obedience, because what does it really mean to obey? Would you obey your friend? Maybe not. Your sister or your brother? No, I don't think you obey your brother or your sister. There are only a few people in our lives that we can trust so fully that we love them by listening to their commandments and obeying them. Because obedience means that we trust those who are giving us instructions. We believe that what they are saying is good and will help us. So we obey God because we trust God, and we obey our mothers because we really do trust them. We can show all of our mothers this day, on Mother's Day, that we love them by continuing to obey them and to show them respect and kindness. Now, before we go, I was thinking that we should also talk about all the ways that we are thankful and grateful for our mothers. So I did a little art project, and I would like to share it with you and then invite you to do the same. So I don't know if you can see, but on construction paper, I drew a picture that kind of looks like my mom, and I made 5 circles or 5 dots with markers. You can also do this with finger paints. I think that could be really fun too. And for each dot, I wrote something that I'm very grateful for about my mother. So you can see the green one. I wrote forgiving. My mom forgave me again and again when I was a child and even still now. Blue, patient. My mom was very patient. She taught me what it meant to wait. She would drive us to sports games and to the library and to all of our practices and our theater practices, and just wait in the car for long times to pick us up. And she was never angry or bitter about it. Instead, she was so loving and excited for all the things that we did. So my mom is very patient. My mom is also really kind. She is so kind with the way in which she cares for us, but also the way that she cares for her students, because she's a teacher. My mom is very hospitable, and that's a really fancy word, but it just means that my mom really cared about taking care of other people and taking care of her children. She made us dinner every single night, and we had family dinner together, and that's something that I remember being so important to not only back then, but to who I am today. And then our very last one, my mom is so generous. She's generous with her time and her talents and her treasures. She gives because she truly wants to. So my challenge for you this week is to draw a picture of your mom and have 5 dots. Again, you can do that either with paint or with marker. And for each one, write one thing that you're grateful about your mom for. It could be anything: that she plays with you, that she takes you to playgrounds, that she helps you with your homework. I'm excited to see what you will choose. And now before we leave, I have one final prayer, and then I was thinking that we could also sing our end song together. Will you do your praying hands with me? God, today we thank you for one of your special gifts to us, our mother. Thank you for the love she shares with us in so many ways.
We thank her for the warmth she gives to our home, for the cuts and bruises she makes well, for the ideas she gives us when we don't have anything to do, for the ways she makes peace when we are mean to each other. We thank her for seeing good in us when we don't see it in ourselves. Help us to love our mother as she loves us, and keep her close to you, God, always. We ask this in the name of Jesus, your beloved Son. Amen. Now, before we go, can we close and go on your way in joy? Go on your way in joy, my friends. Go on your way in joy, my friends. Go on your way in joy, my friends. Let your right foot sing glory and your left sing amen. Very good. Thank you so much for being with me for this special Mother's Day, and I look forward to seeing all of you next week. Bye, everyone.